Melanie Jo Melanson is a missing woman from Woburn, Middlesex County, Massachusetts. She vanished at a party on October 27, 1989. At first, investigators believed she fled to Florida. However, subsequent investigation by both authorities and the private investigator have turned up no leads. She was a freshman in high school and looking forward to a change of schools. She had run away from her home before because of her parents' constant fighting and substance abuse issues. At the time of her disappearance, she was living with her grandmother, yet maintained contact with her parents. She was asked to attend a party on the evening of October 27th, 1989. On the day of her disappearance, Melanson and a friend left school early and decided to go home. That night, she told her grandmother she was going to have a sleepover at a friend's house. The friend was also her next door neighbor. Melanson used the story to cover her attendance at the party. The party was held in a patch of woods near an industrial park. She was the youngest guest. She went with a group of five male friends. The party did not end until early the next morning. No one who knew Melanson saw or heard her returning from the party. During the afternoon of October 28th, after Melanie's family discovered she'd been at the party, they frantically called almost every attendee they could reach. They learned nothing of Melanson's whereabouts. Finally, they reported her missing. The police determined that she was lost seen with two boys she'd known. They gave different stories of what might have happened to her. Police also said each boy claimed the other was the last one who had been with Melanson. One of the boys also said he'd seen her at the very head of a trail in the early morning hours of October 28th. The Woburn Police Department originally thought that Melanson had run off to Florida. She'd run away before, after all. They organized a massive search to find the teenager, using everything from cadaver dogs to helicopters. There were massive digs as well. None of the searches were successful and no clues to her disappearance were found. There have been no arrests in the case. In August 1992, an anonymous caller suggested police should search a pond near the party site. Although police followed up, nothing was found. The Melanson family has been working with a private investigator to find Melanie. In the spring of 2009, authorities announced a renewed push on the case and offered a $5,000 reward for information to solve it. In 2012, a doctor hired in the case used a new science method called decomposition order analysis to help find Melanie. Police now believe she was a victim of foul play and her remains are somewhere near the place where she disappeared. Her grandmother and parents are now deceased. Pretty tragic case. Since their parents are dead after all, so they never ever got closure on this specific part of their life. It also sounds kind of fishy to me that they held a party in a patch of woods near an industrial park. I mean, some people find that cool. It does sound cool, theoretically, but it also makes for a great opportunity for something bad to happen to anyone out there. Was that the case with this young girl at the time? That is the big question. One that so far has never been answered, and sadly, their parents or grandmother will never know because they're already gone. Another thing that makes this case even more tragic to me is the fact that when this girl disappeared, she was only 14 years old. And as was already mentioned, apparently her parents were suffering from substance abuse issues. Now, they must have had their reasons for becoming addicted to whatever they were using, but then imagining that these parents also lost their daughter must have made the situation much worse. But it's kind of clear to me that it's probably one of the reasons why these parents are now deceased, because if their daughter was only 14 years old, unless those parents were really old, doesn't make a lot of sense for 27 years later for these parents to already be dead. Now, of course, maybe the parents were older, then it's possible, but I think it might have something to do with their substance abuse issues as well, making this all way more tragic. Hope in time they'll figure it out. Until then, let's keep the story alive. As always, dear viewer, have sweet dreams.